Hello, and thank you for watching Deer Country's Connected Sport videos. Today, we will learn about an exciting new feature called DataSync Setup that allows all your Gen 4 displays on 22.2 or newer software to run on one centralized set of data. All displays need an active JDLink connection for this to be enabled. To demonstrate this, we have a 4640 display connected through remote display access to our Operation Center organization. Adding a new field in LAN will automatically sync to the display without a setup file needed. The updates happen in near real time and will appear on the display almost immediately, as seen here. DataSync works both ways. Edits made on the display can sync back to the Operation Center and other connected displays in your fleet. DataSync status can be viewed on the display by selecting Menu, System, File Manager, and Operation Center. It can also be disabled from this menu. This would be important to disable before erasing setup data from a display. During a factory reset, DataSync setup is automatically disabled to prevent the loss of data. DataSync setup can be enabled on the Operation Center by selecting Setup and DataSync. When selecting DataSync for the first time, you will see a walkthrough guide helping you learn more about DataSync setup and enable the feature. Part of the walkthrough encourages cleaning up your setup data on the Operation Center before syncing to ensure clean data on your displays. After your initial setup, you will see this screen presented before you. From here, you can enable or disable DataSync on machines. Machines requiring a software update to use this feature will be designated along with recommended updates for displays. Currently, DataSync setup can sync the following setup data: client farm field boundaries, straight and curve guidance lines, excluding adaptive curves, flags, product and tank mixes, and operators. It cannot sync variety locator, auto path, work plans, or equipment profiles, although future updates may allow syncing of those data types. During the initial display syncing, if something exists in the display but not on the Operation Center, it will be archived. If something exists in the Operation Center but not on the display, it will sync. If an item exists in both places, but there are two versions, the last modified date is used to update the item. After the first sync, the import rules from the Operation Center will apply. Those import rules can be edited anytime in the Ops Center org preferences by clicking Import Settings. As an example, in our organization, everything is made to available as new data except for tank mixes, which will automatically archive. Remember, data deleted from an enabled display will be deleted from all other enabled displays and archived in the Operation Center. It can be made available again only from the Operation Center. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe for more videos.